Hi, in this video we're going to be taking a look at a question that was posed by a member of our Facebook page. If you haven't checked out the page, there's loads of tips and tricks, videos, etc. on there. It's www.facebook.com/quantize courses. So the question was, when I drop a sample into simpler or sampler, maybe it's a synth sound or a vocal, and I play it higher up the keyboard, it gets a lot shorter and it might sound, the kind of chipmunk effect, or if it's a synth stab, it becomes really short. Is there a way to overcome that? So the answer is yes, there is. Neither of the devices in question actually have that time stretching functionality, but there is a way around it. So we're going to look at doing that working with this track. Okay, so first thing we'll do is let's have a look at what we actually mean by this problem. I'm just going to throw simpler onto a MIDI track, and I found a synth stab that I like here. Let's just turn this down a touch and make sure we're using C3. So there it is at its usual pitch. When we go right up the keyboard, it obviously becomes really short, so that's a fairly undesirable thing to have happening. So the way that we can get around that is we're going to drag the synth stab, which in this case is a chord playing C minor, and we're going to duplicate that out. Now you can do as many of these duplicates as you want. So you could, for example, have the chromatic scale. In this case, we're not going to go that far. We're just going to do a few. And I'm going to highlight all of these and change my warp mode to texture. And then essentially in each of these, we're just going to change the transpose value. So we'll go for a minor third, perfect fifth, minor seventh, and we'll go one octave up. So as I said, you could do a load of these and map the chromatic scale, wouldn't be a problem. And let's just call this chord pitch. And now these will all be time stretched accordingly. Let's turn that off actually, just so we can hear it in isolation. You can hear that last one is a little bit grainy, so we could adjust the parameters here for the texture warp mode. I'm going to instead go for complex. Let's have a listen. Just double check I've got all of these highlighted when I do that. So that sounds much better. So I'm happy to run with that. Now at this point, you could map this to your MIDI keyboard if you want. So just literally going into MIDI map mode, we could map a different key on the MIDI keyboard to each of these and play it that way. But we're going to take this a step further. Open up a new audio track. And we're going to record the output of chord pitch here. So select chord pitch, highlight this so that we're record armed. And then in order to do that, I'm going to highlight all of these. And let's have a look. I think about half a bar will do. We'll highlight them all. And in the launch follow actions, I'm going to set this up so that every half a bar, a new one is playing. I'll have the next one playing. And then we can simply record this in. So you can see what's happened there. We've now got a recording of all of these playing, and I'm going to crop this. Like so. And the next step to very easily make this playable is to simply, in fact, let's rename this quickly. I'm just going to call this chord pitch again. It's so we can see what we're doing. Right click and slice to new MIDI track. Now we know that we've gone for half a bar for each one of these slices, so we can literally select that straight away. You could use transients and so on, but we've deliberately set that up in the follow action, so it's nice and easy to get the slices that we want. Click OK, and here it is. These are now surplus to requirements. In fact, we can completely delete these. And what we have here, is all of our chords, and we can set these up to do anything we like. In fact, I'm just going to go back a step here and do this one more time, because I've got a slicing preset that I prefer to use that I've made myself for the stabs. It's got slightly more relevant controls to this particular sound. And in fact, let's call these stabs. And we can then program some kind of patterning. So we'll look, if we go for a 4-bar pattern. And so on. So you can see, really easy way of doing this. It's a bit of a workaround, but you can use that on pretty much any different samples that you might have, and depending on the warp mode, you can nearly always find one that's going to work really well, and then you're able to program whatever you like into your MIDI clip. Of course, if you are using sampler, you might want to put the samples in there instead of using the drum rack. Really entirely up to you. So I hope you found the video useful. As always, any questions are very, very welcome, and hope to speak to you soon on the Facebook page. Take care.